Now, as part of After Before Friday, week number 16, I thought that I would show you the steps that I take when I want to convert a color photo into black and white. And I thought that this was a good candidate for that treatment. I don't like the orange handle in the foreground, and the green, the spottiness of the green in the background just tends to draw my eye away from the hat. So the first thing where I do my initial conversion is I come into the HSL tab. There's two places in Lightroom you can do the conversion. You can go into the Basics tab and hit the black and white, or you can come down to the HSL and you can choose black and white here. I've always been taught to do it here. You click in that. And you can play with the black and white mix in Lightroom to achieve the desired effects you want. For instance, knowing that there's orange here down on this handle, if I click this targeted adjustment tool and I move my cursor down to the left foreground onto that orange handle, and I left click my mouse and I scroll up and down, you'll see that it changes the tonality of that orange. It targets the colors in that handle and moves them accordingly. But let me come back here and okay, make sure that everything's reset. I'm going to not play with the individual colors. I'm just going to do a straight conversion into black and white. And from here, I am going to export it into a different program. I am using right now Nik Efex. And I have a trial version, but I happen to like it. And I'm going to show you what this entails. I will, to bring it into that program, I right-click on my mouse. It pulls up this menu, edit in, and you can see the choices that I have because these are the programs that are loaded onto my computer, Photoshop, or into the Nik Efex program. And this is Color Effects Pro. So I'm going to click on that. It gives me this menu. I want to edit a copy with Lightroom adjustments because I want to bring the post-process photo into the Nik Efex program. I will click on that and I already have it's going to load and it will import this photo as is into Color Effects Pro. You see, I'm still buy or demoing, so I'm going to click on demo and it will bring it in. And the beauty about this program is that when I am done making my adjustments, I can choose export or save, and it will bring it right back into Lightroom for me. So it's going to think and pull up my image. And here we go. This is where it starts. For some reason, it already has a choice loaded in here. I'm going to empty the filter and start from scratch. There are so many choices in Nik Efex to play with, and this is a great program that you can use to continue to post-process color photos, but it's also very powerful for black and white. And it took me trial and error to find out that as you click on the right panel, there's all different choices within each choice. So be sure that if you play with this, that you can pull up all your choices by clicking over here on the icons. I have chosen and set up as favorites a number of presets, and you do that by clicking on the stars, and it will automatically load them into the favorites program. So I'm going to go into my favorites, and I'm going to pull up some of these and see how they work with the cowboy hat. The first thing, one of my favorites is Pro Contrast. I'm going to click on the icon and bring up the different choices, and typically, I will use either auto or dynamic enhance. So here's the auto. I will left click on it and bring up what that looks like. And then I'm going to go to dynamic contrast. And you'll see the difference, just slight difference, but for me, it just pops, the dynamic just pops a little bit more. So I'm going to stay with the dynamic contrast. I want to keep that filter in the mix, so I come over to the right and I click add filter. And then I'm going to go back to my favorites. I'm going to hit the back button, go back to my favorites, and I'm going to choose another effect to load in. White neutralizer is something that I also can give some nice results. It's just a little bit different tone. And I'll click on each to show you. This says fix warm whites. Let's get into this beforehand. Fix warm wipes. Here's the strong warmth removal, very blue, very purple, something I've never chosen. The wedding dresses, however, just gives it a little bit more of a pop. And I can show you if I come back over to the right panel and I click on the check mark, I can remove it. It's kind of like a little preview. And when I click it back on, it will load it back in. The change is subtle, but it just gives it a little bit of warmth. So I'm going to keep that for the hat. And I'm going to add one more filter, add filter. I'm going to come back. And I just found this one the other day, darken, lighten, center. And sometimes this effect is really nice. I'm going to go into the default to load the effect first. And then I want to show you the other two. Here's brighten edges. Okay, you can see that. I'm going to come in and click this off so you can see what happens. It does okay, not anything great. The maximum depth, however, really changes the dynamic of the photo. Let me click it on and off so you can see. So that's before the maximum depth on the darken, lighten, center, and with it applied. It's almost like a vignette, and I could certainly probably accomplish this in Lightroom using a radial filter, but this is very simple, and there's certainly some other adjustments in here as well. And I can change, you see the sliders here, I can change the values, and I'll show you. I can lighten the borders, which certainly does defeat the purpose of this specific preset. I can make the center a little bit less bright. If I felt it was too bright, I can also change the shape of the center. And you can see if I toggle back and forth between the two, whoops, what that will do. Just elongates versus more square in the center. And because my point of focus is the center, I'm going to keep it on center lumosity. So those are the three filters I wish to apply. And all I need to do to get this back into Lightroom is to come down and hit save. And it's going to save the image, process it, and then my Lightroom screen is going to open back up. And you'll see that in just a second. There we go. So here is the image, and let me pull out my, there's the image that was imported. I'm going to go back to, let me open all my tabs. I'm going to go back to the history there of the photo that I exported to Nik Efex. So you can see the difference. That's what I took it in when I took it into the program. And this is as I exported it out. Now, it's interesting because the center does look a little bit bright to me, but oftentimes when I ultimately export this from Lightroom, it will the tones just change a bit. So I might, let's see if I come back in here, bring down the highlights just a little bit. It'll decrease the brightness here in the middle. And now I'm going to export. It using my export function. But that is the final photo. I'm going to take you back to the before. I'll take you back in history to the original. I'll click in there. And my Lightroom is thinking. That was the original image. And as it loads, and there is the actor. And focused on the hat itself. So there you have it, before, after, black and white conversion. I hope you've enjoyed this week's presentation using a combination of the gallery and the video. Please feel free to ask any questions you may have in the comments section, and to see more post-processing videos and galleries of after before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks for watching.